This video is intended to aid in the maintenance of the George Fisher 5 Series diaphragm valves. Let's get you familiar with the valve components. First, you have the handle, then the housing nut, the inner housing assembly, spindle assembly, including the diaphragm holder, the compressor, and the diaphragm. Below all of these components is the valve body itself. Before getting started, the tools you need will be either a strap wrench for 1/2 to 1 inch valves, or a valve nut key for 1 1/4 to 2 inch valves. You will also need a small screwdriver to remove the valve handle, and an adjustable wrench with a small pipe section for additional leverage as may be necessary for the valve nut key. In this video, we will service the valve while installed in the piping system. Before beginning any work on the valve, consult the operation and maintenance section of the instruction manual. Observe safety precautions, including the use of protective clothing, gloves, and face protection. Be sure to properly support the valves in the piping system prior to applying any force to loosen the orange nut. Do not apply force to an unsupported valve, as the stress may cause damage to the piping system. Insert the screwdriver in the small hole located closest to the GF logo on the valve handle. At this point, you will be able to dislodge the handle assembly and remove it. Using the strap wrench or valve nut key, turn the housing nut counterclockwise until it becomes loose. Once loose, you can remove the nut by hand and place it aside. Pull the assembly, including the inner housing, spindle, compressor, and diaphragm from the valve body. Holding on to the inner housing, turn the spindle clockwise until it stops. Remove the diaphragm by turning it counterclockwise. If the compressor drops out, realign it by matching the longer ribs of the compressor with the groove pin on the diaphragm holder. This is attached to the spindle assembly. If you are using a PTFE diaphragm, be sure that the tabs on the PTFE are aligned with the tabs on the elastomer portion of the diaphragm. Take the new diaphragm and, ensuring the compressor is aligned as previously described, screw on the diaphragm until hand tight. Then, back it off 1/4 turn. While holding on to the inner housing, turn the spindle assembly counterclockwise until it stops. Note, when replacing the diaphragm, be sure to remove the old diaphragm material type indicator on the valve body and replace it with the new one included in the replacement diaphragm packaging. Insert this assembly back into the valve body, ensuring that the tabs on the diaphragm and the grooves on the inner housing align with the valve body. It is now time to reinstall the orange housing nut. Turn it hand tight, and then, using the strap wrench or valve nut key, tighten the nut until the small square alignment tab on the orange nut lines up with the diaphragm material type indicator. The last item to be installed is the handle. Line up the largest groove on the handle with the largest tooth on the spindle. Place the handle over the spindle and turn 1 full turn clockwise. The handle will lock in place at this point. The assembly is now complete, and the valve is ready to go back into service.